Well, I always thought of myself, and I hope I'm gonna qualify this by saying that I only get better, I hope, with every passing year. Part of my what I like to do every year is look back at my work and kind of cringe a little. And I go, okay, that means I'm hopefully getting better because I like what I'm doing now. So, but to answer the question about, you know, inking for the first time and seeing how that transposed my pencils, I always was a tight penciler, whether I was good enough or not, but I was always a tight penciler. And then adding a certain depth to those pencil lines, because I didn't shade. I was pretty, like, I used like a 4H pencil. Or I remember using a 7H once, and I was like drawing with a nail. That was bizarre. But I didn't really go for the B pencils that you could get almost like a brush kind of quality line out of it. I just went with the harder pencils. Maybe because when you go to school, it's a 2H, I think, or something. But I was more inclined to use something that was stiffer for some reason. I like to have like hard edge lines, I guess. And that could also speak to the fact that a lot of the artwork I liked to look at and I was studying was more boxy, like a Jack Kirby or later on a Mike Mignola or something, where I like where it's more shape oriented. And you know, it's like outlines in a way. So, but when I started inking myself, I think I was really heavy on the brush. And I remember now when I look back at it, I'm like, wow, what was I doing? Like, it was almost like I was inking with my elbow or something. Like, there was nothing delicate about it, you know? Now I try to go for the delicacy. In fact, I try to go for what I call deliberate accidents, where you don't have as much control because I'm such a controlled artist. There's something I like about just being able to kind of maybe not think for a second and let something happen and get like a pull, a drag of the brush to create something that I couldn't have thought of. That way you're working with the tool, not against it. And you're not controlling it in a way where you're like, I'm just going to do this line now and I know exactly what it's going to look like. What's the fun of that? Sure, you have to be on point and on model for certain jobs, especially if you're drawing, you know, doing something for like a Marvel DC where, you know, you... Well, actually, that's not true. These days, you have a lot more latitude of how to draw a character. But growing up, there was the House of Ideas. There was like draw comics the Marvel way. I mean, there were so many, you know, on model type ways of drawing, you know, that all, you know, stemmed from Jack Kirby and Steve Ditko and those guys. And then John Buscema and John Romita and those guys. But still, there was like a certain house style. You knew what a Marvel comic looked like versus a DC comic back then. Now, it runs the gamut, you know, thankfully. Yeah, I think inking was, you know, brought a whole new depth to my art. And I thought about, you know, in the pencils, I shaped the story a certain way. It looked a certain way. And I got that. And that was cool. Then I go ink it. I add another flair to it. And it wasn't until recently, like when I worked on Cuba My Revolution, where it wasn't inked. It was, quote, digitally inked. And really what that means is they scan in the pencils. And I worked with colorist Jose Villarubia, who would kind of tweak my pencils. And we decided to keep kind of show the pencils, you know, not try to hide the fact that it was pencils and use that for that particular story. And then he would color, and we chose two colors to use between grays and reds of how to like show this story. But I remember it was my idea to not ink it. And then I started to see the pages coming back, and I loved what Jose was doing, but I started to go, oh no, did I make a horrible mistake? Should I be showing the public my pencils? You know, you can do that on a blog where you show like a process, but that was going to be the finished piece in that book, you know, these pencils. And the editor, Joan Hilty, and the writer, Inverna Lopez, and Jose Villarubia all convinced me, no, it's okay, this looks cool, it serves the story. And since then, I started playing more with my pencil like it's a brush. And I use blue pencils now, but luckily with scanning and the technology, you can turn any scan into any color you want, and you can tweak it and all that stuff, and I'm still learning the technology. But it also cuts a step out of the process. I mean, you sit there, and, you know, I'll do a layout, and then I figured out how to show the story in the page, right? And then I go to execute it in pencils, and often I do tight pencils because an editor or the writer needs to approve it and make sure that I'm doing the job right. And then I go in and I ink it. By the time I've actually started get to inking nowadays, I'm a little bored, frankly, because the pencils are so tight that I'm not going to go in and like now mess it up with the inks. You know, I have a job to serve. So I'm kind of having a struggle these days with inking because of technology, because of process, because of time. You know, I've drawn that story three times now, basically, from layout to pencils to inks, that I want to cut out a step. What I'd prefer to do in the future is to be able to just take my layouts and go to inks if I want to use, you know, a brush to make the story look a certain way. But also, I'm discovering that maybe I could just use the pencils and then it's done. So I'm hopscotching between, you know, what would a story look best served, you know, via pencil or go to full inks. It really depends.